Teaching an online class involves many types of interactions and many types of relationships. In the past, you know, a lot of us see online as well as face-to-face teaching as something that's didactic in nature. It's from me, the teacher, instructor, or trainer, to you, the learner. Online learning offers us a chance to rethink that kind of philosophy or framework and involve many other players and resources that we might not traditionally think about. So let's take a look at some of this that we've been putting together on this topic here on online student-instructor-practitioner relationships, brought to you by the School of Education at Indiana University. You know, there, as I said, types of relationships, types of tasks. There are so many different kinds of tasks, cases, problems, simulations, papers, writing to experts, analyzing real-world data and financial statements if it's a business class, you know, taking a simulation in a medical class, which you might do with your peers, which you might have experts giving you feedback on, which you might have instructors monitoring what you're doing. You might be, in fact, as a student, providing things to students, writing up tasks, as well as providing things to instructors or practitioners, and they might be giving you things. It's not always from one person vertically down to the learner. It's a little bit more coequal, more horizontal in nature in terms of the types of ways of interacting. And so the interactions are many. We can involve with the web practitioners who come to you through a webcam, who come to you through a chat, who might analyze your wiki posts or blog posts or your discussion forum, or your gallery of your work on the web. It might come from peers who give you feedback on your work as your critical friend or your email pal. It might come from a learner reflecting on his or her growth within an assignment or across the class. So the learner can analyze and give feedback. That could be the interaction. The content could tell you whether or not you got something correct or not. It could provide a stimulus, a response within the system. Good job, you're on the right track, you're going in the right direction. So think beyond the box. Open it up a little bit beyond instructor to student and student to instructor to what students can do with other students and with practitioners and with the funds of capital in your community. Could we have a Google group activity or a Yahoo group activity among a small team or the entire class or cross-class situations? Could we encourage students to provide feedback and maybe rely on one another for support structures within the class so they're not just relying on the instructors? Could the students be the instructor for a week, sign up to teach something? Could the students then in turn reflect on what happened within that activity? You know, so you've got to, as an instructor, plan for these events. Think about how you might utilize those resources and structure things within the environment so as you're not the only one who's in and they're relying upon for their learning. The book is important. Ebooks are important. Peers are important. Experts are important. Portals are important. PowerPoints like this are important. Videos like this are important. How can we use Web 2.0 technology like Facebook to get students to interact with one another on the web, right? This is a natural social networking. I mean, we've got tens of millions of people, more than 100 million in the U.S. now today, in Facebook, or using MySpace, or LinkedIn, or some other networking tool, LinkedIn being more professional in nature. They might be using Ning, N-I-N-G, built by Mark Andreessen, who brought us Netscape, now brings us Ning. More than a million groups in Ning with threaded discussions, and you can have profiles, and you can have pictures, and you can have videos you post in your own page. You can create community within a Ning group, but it also fosters interaction among your students. You can use social bookmarking like Indigo and index websites that you find, or in Delicious, some social bookmarking websites. If you find interesting web resources, how about cataloging those resources, making them available for your peers within the class? Challenges, of course, are many when you're trying to build interaction because we're not used to bringing in practitioners to your class or guests oftentimes to your class. But heck, at your fingertips, at your click of the keyboard, is thousands and thousands of websites and millions of people that you bring into your class as an expert or as someone who might provide information. There are other challenges. The challenge to a class online is the fact that courses oftentimes are created self-paced with no interaction. I do this, I do that. Oftentimes corporate online classes are that way. There's no interaction from anyone. And then people drop out like flies. They're not going to survive in that kind of a class situation. And if you built a class that way, you have to rethink it for interaction of other people, even if it's just learner self-interaction, even if it's just learner content interaction, you see. And another problem we have is pre-assigning the interaction patterns. Sometimes students don't like the groups they've been assigned to. Sometimes they don't like the roles they've been assigned to, the devil's advocate or the bloodletter. Sometimes they might not like the avatar. I once assigned a woman to beat Jabba the Hutt. She really didn't like me all that much. I apologized to her at the end of the semester. Everyone wanted to be Obi-Wan or Luke or Princess Leia, right? Advice. Get students to rely on each other and not just the instructor. You don't want the instructor to be the thesaurus. You don't want the instructor to be the encyclopedia or the memory bank or the syllabus. You can get beyond that list, people who possibly you can use. And once you use some people and bring in some practitioners and they're good, create maintain a list of those guests. There are websites where you can get live people into your class. Some of these cost money, some are free. In practitioners is actually a new website for a live happy iPhone practitioner directory where you can get people to make you happy and bring them into your class or whatever psychologists out there. But my point is that there are so many ways to tap into people that can enliven and enrich your class and build new connections for your students. So diversify those interactions beyond the instructor, beyond even student-student, to other kinds of people, players, and resources. Create a learning environment approach to your class. Think about the big picture and what you're attempting to do. When you do that, it becomes less me to you and more of a playing field, which is a smorgasbord of things you can pick and choose from. And that's the advantage of online learning. It's the advantage of having so much, but structuring it so that, you know, you've got interaction. We've got a social constructivistic framework where students rely on each other for knowledge. It's the social activities that springboard internal cognitive mental functionings. We move from the social to the internal, intermental to intra psychological processing, and archive those things that worked so other students see what worked, what didn't work, and so forth. Maintain a list so you might reuse some kind of interaction in a future semester of a class or course offering. Assign reflection papers at the end of all this stuff that you tried to do to see if students picked up on the interactions that you were attempting within the class and the purpose and rationale for it. See if they've internalized some of that and what they've benefited from. Maybe you could change it in future semesters. There are many types of interactions today, many things that you can do to build student interaction and reflection on what's going on. Some of these things involve other people beyond your university or corporate training center or school or military setting, wherever you are at teaching today. They might involve other resources, portals. They might involve a combination of those people and portal resources. They might just involve utilizing the peers in the class. But think about each task that you assign and how you might foster reflection and interaction utilizing them, student-student, student-instructor, student-practitioner, student-content, student-self. Use them all. They're available for you. And have fun when you do.